Good morning and welcome everyone. Before we start, I'd like to acknowledge the Gadigal people of the Eora Nation, the traditional custodians of this land, and to pay my respects to their elders, past, present, and emerging. Now, it's my pleasure to join you today and welcome you to the 2021 Macquarie Australia Conference. Now in its 23rd year, this event brings together capital and ideas for global investors interested in the opportunities and themes playing out in the Australian market and some of our most dynamic companies. This year, we're proud to feature over 100 Australian and New Zealand companies from different sectors, each confronting current challenges and new opportunities in their own way, presenting to an audience of more than 500 investors from all over the world. The 2020 Australia Conference was the first significant virtual event of its type in this market, and given the positive feedback we've received, we've continued in a virtual format this year. I'm hoping that easing travel restrictions will mean that we can move to a hybrid format in 2022. Now, this time last year, like peers around the world, the Australian government was finalising the implementation of a major lockdown to curb the spread of COVID-19 in Australia. And so then in my opening address, I spoke about Australia's strong market fundamentals and underlying stability, as well as the opportunities that would doubtlessly emerge from weathering the many challenges presented by the pandemic. As we stand here today, the resilience demonstrated across the market in response to those challenges during the past year is clearly evident, and you'll hear many examples across the breadth of attendees from many sectors presenting this week. This collective response from our governments, health professionals, and businesses through a highly unpredictable set of circumstances has always been a characteristic underpinning business success in Australia. And what we've seen, and indeed what we're seeing now as we transition out of the other side of these situations, is an emergence of real opportunity. So despite immense uncertainty and uneven pace of recovery in different markets, disruption continues to present possibilities for all businesses to reimagine their potential. Enduring global themes like digitalization, our transition to a low carbon future, and the rapid evolution of services like health and education are particularly relevant to this region's strong emergence from the pandemic. Following one of the largest economic shocks since the 1930s, the global economic recovery is now well underway, with GDP likely to expand by a rapid 5.5% over the course of this year. In general, the countries that have controlled the virus the best have seen the strongest recoveries, with China and Australia outperforming over last year. Now, the US is likely to lead the way in 2021 as the fiscal stimulus and the rapid vaccine rollout allow economic reopening. But Australia is still expecting to this year outperform most other economies. I'd like to spend a minute reflecting a little on these themes a bit more and our collective adaptation to the challenging situation we found ourselves in. Technology is changing how we live and work at a faster pace than any period in our history. And while navigating that change, the challenge for investors and businesses is identifying the greatest opportunities and threats and what to do about them. We only have to look at the success with which large portions of our economies were able to transition so quickly out of the traditional work environments and continue to change their business models during the last year to see this in action. It's been eye-opening to witness how we can continue to get the job done and indeed make permanent shifts that lead to better outcomes. At Macquarie, we're seeing technology-related opportunities in areas as diverse as digital infrastructure, like data centres, logistics, and high-speed internet connectivity, as well as the digitalisation of consumer services, where we've made investments in innovative businesses moving the provision of many aspects of life online. We have many impressive local technology companies presenting this week, and we'll further expand on these ideas at the Global Macquarie Technology Summit, which we're hosting in June. Climate change is one of the most complex and critical challenges facing the world, and it's heartening to see the material increase in concrete initiatives from countries and companies in the lead up to the UN's Climate Change Conference in Glasgow in November. We can be confident that we know that the best approach to reaching the necessary targets is a strong partnership between the public and private sectors. And those of us in this virtual room hold many of the solutions to effect the vast scale of change that's needed. We're broadly engaged with investors on their responsible investment strategies as they seek to meet the expectations of savers and pension holders whose capital they manage. It requires granular action at the asset level to repurpose and upgrade to reduce emissions and improve resilience. And we're proud also to count ourselves as one of the many leaders in the progressive green finance, with established global businesses working on emissions reduction across energy, agriculture, waste, and real estate. A number of subtrends are emerging, including enabling technologies to achieve more ambitious targets, such as carbon capture, storage through batteries and hydrogen, and the continuing transition to low emissions transport. Despite the limitations of the pandemic, its imperatives advance the pace of change at the intersection of health and technology. COVID-19 has underpinned the growth of telehealth services and the uptake of digitized health records, both of which are changing the face of health services. And the advantage to Australia and New Zealand from managing and containing the virus, in part through effective use of health technologies, is delivering clear dividends in a global comparative sense. Despite the ongoing risks, the Australian economic recovery continues to lead the world, with medical success allowing the government to reopen much of the economy. And this, along with ongoing monetary and fiscal support, has seen employment surpass pre-COVID levels, with GDP also likely to now be touching a new high. Investment is occurring across sectors, including areas of traditional strength, such as infrastructure and commodities. And while our vaccine rollout has started slowly, very low rates of COVID infection have allowed much of the economy to return toward normal. As the program picks up pace, the success of the mass inoculation programs in places like Israel suggests that we will be able to further normalize as the year progresses and eventually reopen our borders so that some of you can join us here next year in person. At the same time, we're still navigating the challenges of the pandemic, and many of our friends, families, clients, and partners remain in long lockdowns around the world. Improvements in some markets are offset by new waves in others. With the vaccine program now well underway around the world, we're seeing divergence in both medical and economic outcomes, with rises in cases hitting fresh highs in recent weeks, particularly in emerging markets where the vaccine rollout is yet to gain momentum. But the vaccine production is happening at full tilt. Teething problems are being ironed out and access is improving. And the world's ability to develop vaccines in record time is testament to the ingenuity of humans, while continued activity and innovation across our economies speaks to our optimism and resilience as a race. And on that note, on behalf of Macquarie, I would like to welcome you again to the conference and thank you very much for joining us virtually from your homes and your offices. I hope you enjoy the week and the many ideas emerging from it.